When Joe Berry's politician father, Sir Anthony Berry, was murdered by the IRA, her reaction was shock and anger, especially toward Patrick McGee, the man who planted the bomb. Let's hear from them both.
In 1984, we targeted the Grand Hotel in Brighton, where the Conservative Party were holding a conference.
My sister woke me up and said, "Which hotel is Dad in? There's been a bomb in Brighton. It's on the news."
In that operation, 5 people were killed. Over 30 people were injured.
How dare anybody think their need to be heard is so important that they've killed my father?
That is just a snippet from a remarkable new documentary, Beyond Right and Wrong. 3 decades on, Joe Berry has made peace with the man who murdered her dad. She's here with us today along with documentary maker Laika Singh. Ladies, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having
us. Jo, let's start with you. Where do we start? How difficult was it for you to make contact with the man who murdered your father?
It was very easy to meet him in terms of finding a venue and for him to agree, but a long journey to be ready to meet him, because I wanted to see him as a human being, and that meant letting go of my anger and my rage so I could listen to him.
Is that something you learned from your father, to let go of your rage?
No, I don't know where I learned that from, but it was something that I wanted to learn after the bomb killed my father.
Take us back to that very first meeting. Yeah. What was your initial impression of the man who murdered your dad?
As soon as I saw him, I could see he was actually gentle, which wasn't what I expected, and had sensitivity. But he was also giving me the reasons why he thought planting the bomb at the Grand Hotel was a good idea, was a strategy. And so I was thinking, I'm not going to come back for a second visit, but I have actually seen his humanity. But then he changed. He opened up and became vulnerable, and a new journey started. And he began to see that he actually killed a real wonderful human being rather than just a target.
So when you first met him, did he say sorry? Did he express remorse? Or was he still defending his actions as in pursuit of a greater cause?
Well, he started off defending his actions. Then he opened up and he said he was really sorry. And he began to sort of emotionally connect with what he'd done, with the loss and with the trauma he'd left behind. But when he actually met me, he was not aware of that. He was, like, cut off from that part of him.
But how have you managed to forgive him? Because I think... I know I would find it very difficult. It's one thing to seek someone out to find out what they're like, but this man killed your father.
I think it's more about understanding and empathy. And I've heard so much about his life and the conditions that he was living in that I can understand why he chose to join the IRA. I don't agree with violence ever, but that's different from understanding. And I now see how much he's trying to bring positive peace back into the world. You know, and that touches me. And how he now knows he could sit down and have a cup of tea with my dad. So he now lives with that terrible pain of knowing that he's responsible for killing not just my father, but others. Mm.
In fact, you haven't forgiven him. You don't like to use the word forgiveness in these types of situations, you've said.
Well, I call him now my friend, and it's an unusual friendship. So, yes, I probably have forgiven him. But whatever it is, it's a journey, it's difficult, it's complex, and it's actually beyond forgiveness, I think, is what is happening. But it's every day choosing to see his humanity and not to blame him and seek revenge.
And, Laika, speaking of going beyond things, your documentary is Beyond Right and Wrong. How unusual is it for the victim of what is a heinous crime, a murder, to forgive the people who have robbed them of so much?
It is very unusual, and that's the reason why I made this film, because it was shocking. Actually, concepts like forgiveness are very radical, and they're the most disruptive concepts that we can think about and live out. And just to add to Joe's answer, I think it's a moment, what I've learned from talking to a lot of people who've forgiven or reconciled at least, it's a moment by moment thing. A woman I talked to said that when she's earning good money, she can forgive. But when she's not, she can't forgive. So it's a moment by moment process, and the anger comes up all the time as well.
Should people... I always think, I mean, it's extraordinary that people can forgive those who have done terrible things to them, and it's a very sort of, I suppose, small C Christian thing to do. It's a very noble thing to do, mm-hmm. but they shouldn't have to, should they? I mean, if mm-hmm. someone has a terrible thing done to them, mm-hmm. it's okay to hate. In fact, it's mm-hmm. natural, it's right mm-hmm. to despise that person.
Yes, it's completely right, and it's completely, that's why this is beyond right and wrong, and it's about healing rather than focusing on the horror. So it's more about the person who has been perpetrated upon than the perpetrator. Or
I suppose the thing is that we don't often look at terror attacks and killings from that perspective. And I presume that that's what your documentary is all about. Mm-hmm. Look at the other side mm-hmm. of the act of violence.
It's a bit about that, but it's more about the courage it takes to move on. And it's more about how to move on after something really bad has happened. And it's not political, it's not psychological, it's basically human, you know. How do you heal and not keep that in yourself? Like one of the characters in the film says, he was in prison, but I was his prisoner. Meaning that although he was in prison and he, you know, there was a judgment upon him, et cetera, he was still in prison himself as a victim because he carried it with him, you know.
Has this friendship, Joe, with Patrick McGee helped you heal?
It is all about my healing, yeah. And I'm actually grateful that he's engaging to work with me because I am being transformed and I am being healed. And every time we speak together, and we've spoken maybe over 150 times, I learn something more about myself or I have a healing. And I definitely agree, there's a lot of pressure on victims to forgive before they're ready. And I think it's about a journey in which every moment all emotions are understandable and can be transformed. But it's hard work and everyone needs support for the process.
All right, Joe and Lika, thank you very much for coming in and sharing your stories. And to find out more about the documentary, go to filmraise.com.